that's all you have? Where the hell you been?
I'd like to know the answer to that myself. But first, we're gonna revisit a murder. I checked the schedule. You're all free for the next few hours.
Free to do what?
Environmental service. I think you'll all fit in my car. It's a short ride.
What if I said I didn't want to go with you?
I'd advise against that.
What if I did?
You'd be coming with me in handcuffs.
I think it's better you just go along with this one.
Yeah, that's good advice. In fact, you know, I was within 2 hours of putting out an APB on you.
Yeah? Well, I'm here now. Right, Mac?
I don't understand. We've already answered every question you have about that night.
There's still a murder to be solved. Unless one of you want to confess right now, save us the trouble.
Look, Mac, we're all, we're pretty busy around here.
I think you'd want to be anxious to clear your name.
Well, we are. I mean, of course we are.
Good, fine. Then I'll get the car.
All right, well, I have to call the babysitter and make sure she can pick
up. You can do it on the way, Robin.
It's just easier if I meet you at the station.
We're not going to the station.
Why are we here?
Looks like the police ran out of ideas.
I can't believe Dante would do this to his own mother.
When Dante's doing his job, he doesn't think about his personal life.
Unlike the rest of you, I wasn't even on this boat when Lisa was killed.
And your hands are always clean, right? No violence in your past.
You'd think you'd learned a little humility by now, Doc.
Oh, you are right, Max Meester. The Jackal's confident he can solve this mystery and get you out of here.
I'm sure he'll try. Do you have any idea how worried I've been?
Sorry.
Hello? Can we get the show on the road?
Have a seat, everyone. You all remember First Officer Briggs? Please have a seat. Thank you all for coming.
Not like we had a choice.
This boat is the scene of a crime. The place where Lisa Niles was murdered.
I've taken care of everything.
Everyone who was on the boat that night is in this room, with the exception of Elizabeth Weber, who had already been thrown overboard by the time the murder happened, and Captain McLeod, who Lisa Niles killed.
Excuse me, Officer Padilla.
Who said you can interrupt?
I just thought you might show some compassion and offer that poor woman a tissue.
I'm fine. Thank you.
Not to sound insensitive, but this really has nothing to do with me. I wasn't on this boat.
You were seeing piloting another boat.
You just decided to tell everybody that now, Johnny?
Your pop was spotted on the dock from where the boat launched.
It's a crime to take a walk by the water?
Spinelli was also on a boat nearby that night. So now you all know why you're here.
Someone on this boat killed Lisa Niles. With this. Divers got lucky. Although the killer wasn't very creative in trying to get rid of it, it was found at the bottom, right where the boat had been anchored.
Yeah, as the car is on the water,
that's right,
on the boat.
Sit down. Look, as you all know, we look for three elements of a crime.
Motive, means, enough.
Put your hand down, Spinelli. That's right. The wrench was the means. Forensics made a positive match with the blow that killed Lisa.
The murder weapon was in a toolbox readily available to anyone on the boat.
So the opportunity could have presented itself to any one of you. Including those of you trolling the waters. So that leaves motive.
You all had reason why Lisa Niles gone.
Oh, really, Detective? Thank you for that revelation.
Don't mention it. Robin, this is the watch you wore the night of the murder, right?
Yeah, it was broken in the struggle with Lisa.
And what does that have to do with anything?
The hands were frozen at 9:49, which gives us a bit of an indication of when Lisa was killed. And as per the statements, Robin was the last person to see Lisa alive.
Actually, Detective, you have that wrong.
Is there something you want to say, Patrick?
You don't have to say anything.
The last person to see Lisa alive was the killer. That's not Robin.
You sure about that, Dr.
Yeah, I'm sure about that, Detective. My wife's innocent.
Well, Dr. Niles tried to kill your wife many times, right? I mean, Robin just admitted right now to fighting with her night of the murder.
Dr. Robin? Unlikely. She's a mother and a gentle soul if ever there was one. Still, when one's under attack, love and remorse in equal measure could drive a man to a desperate act.
Sounds like you've got your man. Are we done here?
You know, we checked with the coma facility. You had power of attorney over Lisa.
She was alone in that hospital. I'm a humanitarian.
You authorized the treatment that brought her out of the coma.
So why would I give her a tune-up with a wrench?
Maybe you had an arrangement with her, and something went wrong.
Maybe the monster turned on her creator and he had to put her down.
When's it my turn?
How about right now?
John, you had a relationship with Lisa, yeah?
Yeah, it wouldn't be the first relationship I've had. Yeah.
So, maybe you helped her get on that boat that night?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Or maybe you knew what she was gonna do, and you tried to stop her.
Unable to save Lisa, he was forced to stop her.
The ways of mayhem are well known to Johnny. Would he be this careless?
Dr. Weber.
Bet you never get to me.
You used to date Lisa Niles, right?
We had a brief relationship back when I thought she was sane.
Now, were you upset with her for using you, or more upset with yourself for not seeing what she was capable of?
And I'm wondering how you got those scratches on your face the night of the murder.
The investigators would know if they found Steve's DNA under Lisa's fingernails, but they weren't sane.
All right, that brings me to Dr. Weber's girlfriend, Olivia. Come on, you couldn't have liked the fact that Steve-O used to dance with Niles.
You know what, Ron? Steve's past doesn't concern me.
Well, I've seen jealousy make people act out in ways they didn't think was possible.
Could such a great hatred fit in so small a package?
Dr. Hunter, detective, where have you been? I haven't seen you around lately.
Oh, did you miss me, buddy?
Yeah.
Feeling's not mutual.
Okay, I heard that you were under the influence that night.
Drunk as a skunk.
And pretty angry. Like you wanted to hurt somebody. Maybe you thought Lisa Niles would be a decent target.
Dare I hope to eliminate a rival for her hand?
No, Matt's not a mean or violent drunk.
Well, there's a ringing endorsement. What about you, princess?
Me? Mac!
You were there that night.
Yeah, you had access to grind. Lisa shot the guy you almost married.
Cease and desist. Maximista is blameless.
That's enough out of you, Spinelli. Listen, Lisa shot you, turned your life upside down.
Yeah, but the jackal is trying to...
I don't want to hear about the jackal. All right? You're just as much a suspect as anyone. Sit down.
Spinelli didn't do it. He couldn't have.
Well, it sounds like you know who did.
You guys have proven your point, okay? We all wanted Lisa dead.
But it doesn't really matter because you have no evidence as to who actually killed her, do you?
Actually, that's not entirely true.
We're able to lift fingerprints, including yours, Steve and Olivia.
We told you we were working on the engine, Dante.
The lab also detected traces of dye. From a leather shoe.
Those of you who provided us with the clothes you were wearing the night of the murder gave us additional information.
Robin, a strand of your hair was found on that wrench.
We fought. I'm sure my hair came off on her.
Matt, there were traces of bar sugar on the soles of your shoes, the same sugar that was found near the deck area where Lisa fell into the water.
Yes, because I was all over the boat looking for Elizabeth.
We also found a hair from Dr. Niles on your uniform.
The woman knocked me out and took my clothes. I was unconscious the whole time.
I'm sure the late Captain McCloud would have been very appreciative of your cooperation. It's obvious you were fond of him.
Yes.
You know, this is all really interesting, but if you had anything conclusive, you'd be making arrests right now instead of playing...
If you hadn't told... Where have you been the last few days, all right? You haven't answered that question.
It's not relevant.
Just tell them where you were.
I don't have to do that.
God, what is wrong with you after everything that I've done for you?
What have you done?
I just mean... I told everybody that you weren't going to run away because why would you? I mean, innocent people don't run away, and innocent people stay home with their girlfriend.
Okay, all right, we get it. We get it.
Matt is no killer. I mean, I couldn't be in love with him if he was.
Enough!
Got something to add, Spinelli?
Look, I don't intend to tell you officers how to do your job.
Then don't.
I'd like to point out that an investigation so wide and diverse only causes to stoke confusion.
Meaning what?
Meaning you should start... eliminating suspects. Starting with Maximista. She has a heart as big as the moon. And she loves life like no one else I know.
I'm sure Lisa Niles loves life, too.
Just Maximista is not a killer.
I mean, has anybody forgotten that there are professional killers on board? I mean, I'm definitely not saying that they could do it. What about Robin? She has motive.
Are you kidding me right now, Maxie? If that's the case, why don't we talk about people who have no problem stepping on anybody to get further in this world?
And now you're going to throw Maxie under the bus because
she just accused
know about
my
your...
wife.
Don't get into it.
No, actually, I want to get into it because I'm annoyed and I want to find out who killed her just as much as anybody else in here.
I didn't realize how charged with violence this room is. All these fine-looking people with so many dark secrets.
Hey, you know what, orange jumpsuit? Why don't you stop trying to deflect the guilt?
You know, I've been to the neighborhood you grew up in, Dutz.
What the hell are you suggesting?
You all claim John and I are the ones who do violence. Are the ones with the capacity to kill? It's in all of you! I see it!
Look at all of you checking each other out. Each wondering if they're sitting next to a killer.
Can you shut him up?
Can I hear more about the scratches on your face?
Indeed, they imply a violent confrontation.
We shouldn't be attacking each other. That's what Lisa wanted. She wanted to terrorize almost every single person in this room.
Well, let's be honest. Lisa was fixated on you and Patrick, which may help to establish motive, but it still doesn't
mean anything.
Maybe
that's true, but she took a lot of us hostage here, and let's not forget she shot Spinelli point blank, which gives him motive also.
I'm not quite sure what you're...
Don't pin this on Spinelli. I mean, he couldn't hurt a fly.
You know what? His best friend and employer is a mob enforcer.
Thank you all very much for coming. We have cars waiting for you outside.
That's it? We can go home?
We'll be making an arrest as soon as we analyze one final bit of evidence.
What evidence?
Someone left something on this boat. So, thank you very much. Have a nice day.
Come on, let's go.
I
need to go get Emma.
Yeah, that was fun. Let's never do that again.
Look, we need to find a place to talk, okay? I need you to explain what you've been up to. You have no idea what I've done to help you.
I'm sorry. I will call you later, okay?